it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophies, supplies, ain't no gimmicks with this, okay? Now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these eyes got nothing on them. I secured it safe, what a credo, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Okay,
a flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Flag on the play.
Hold up.
That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through standing. Call me Ty, girl, and hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, let's go. Ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shaking and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock, just like Tyreek Hill.
Tyreek Hill.
I just count 100 racks, that's a whole field. He don't want no championship, get him out of here. I just got a sack, like I'll run up in the backfield. I just got a sack.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Buffalo Bills and the Miami Dolphins. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go.
And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. The number one mission of any offensive line, you got to protect that quarterback, keep him safe back there. This time, the rush got to him in a hurry.
And it appears that this was just a letdown from the offensive line, but they do have a tough job because if you're a big tackle out there on the perimeter, sometimes you don't have the agility to keep up with the defensive end who's looking to wreak havoc in the backfield, and he got there and put his man on the ground.
They set up the screen to Chubb. A nice move gets him a few extra. Down just shy of his 20. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they'll have great field position here as the ball will be at the 15-yard line. It's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. Giving 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Melvin Gordon, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start 1st and 10. Space to maneuver at the 40. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Nick Chubb, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. Nick Chubb, about as dynamic a runner as the NFL has to offer. He put his talents on full display there. That was some kind of run.
And that's why he's one of the best running backs in the game today, because this run combined all the elements. Started with patience, and he was just waiting for the right lane to materialize. Then once he saw it, he used his speed and escapability in tandem and turned this into a tremendous play.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
A nice burst there as he'll get about 7 that time on the first down run. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3.
Now they run from the gun with Gordon. And he'll be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 36.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Mayfield on first down. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. He'll buy some time right. That is caught at the 7. And he will take it in for the Dolphins touchdown. Cooper Kupp, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And normally when you see guys moving this fast, it might be a fly pattern from a receiver or a toss sweep from a tailback or something like that. This was designed as a passing play, and then he got out of the pocket, and he just took off, and he just kept gaining momentum with every step.
And according to Next Gen Stats, his top speed on that one, better than 20 miles an hour. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. A run for Nick Chubb. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. A tale of two extremes. First carry, he went for a bundle. His 2nd goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up. And sometimes you force a run a little bit, right? Trying to break off that big carry again. And instead, it works opposite.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. That's complete. It's Kyle Juszczyk. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. It's a pickup of 17 on that. They give the Chubb out of the gun. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
They go with Chubb on second down. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And they will finally haul him down at the Dolphins' 25-yard line. A gain there of 30 big ones.
And it is still early, just the first quarter. But you start prorating the numbers, and we might be in for some history. I mean, that last run puts him over 100 yards already, and we've still got three quarters to go.
Down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. They'll look to throw here on first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get it, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. Chubb, and they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed three, he got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. They'll run for it. Chubb, and he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down, and it'll be a turnover on downs. He'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he will double the space they have to work with as they take it from the two to the four.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now Gordon. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. Sets up the screen to Gordon. And they're going to get the first down here across the 15-yard line. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's Gordon. And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. A CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though. And they could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
Third down, Mayfield. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Take over first and 10. at their own 30-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go-around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit. They're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Second and nine now. Side completion to Jones. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
It's a gain of 9. Makes it third.
On third down, it's Nick Chubb. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Now a run on first down is not going to get off the ground as they will get him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of 3.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Second and 13. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 39. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Caught on the right side by Jones. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. He'll look to throw. It's caught. Jones. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 12-yard line. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Rolling to his right. They'll get this to Chubb out of the backfield. Not much there, only a yard. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. And the Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number 1. They'll look to throw here. This is caught. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. A gain of 4 on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
Now that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together and watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
So the snap will come from the 3, but remember, they don't need the touchdown. They can get the first down if they get a yard, and the ball gets to the 2. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, dancing to his left. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Denzel Ward right there in coverage to get the hand in. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down of this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0-for-2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
And he takes it all the way down to the 44-yard line. whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So forget about being backed up. Here's a first and 10 all the way across midfield. Final play of the half, Mayfield. Flushed out right. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. So we've reached halftime here on Halloween. And trust me, kids, if you had to look at Charles Davis every game, you'd think every day was Halloween. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. Taken in the end zone, and he will not bring it out. It's a The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
From the 27, Mayfield forced out to his left. He'll get this one to Cobb, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
At the 41-yard line.
Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Looking for Kelsey on the deep ball. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Play fake, Mayfield. They're trying for Washington, but the pass intercepted. Picked off by Eric Murray. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. First play, the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Once again, the Dolphin defense holds firm as they'll stop him behind the line of scrimmage. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On play action, they'll throw. Eluding the pressure right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. Julio Jones. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Mayfield off the play fake. They'll roll him out right. Going up top for Kopp. And that's caught inside the 35. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A gain of 32 that time. Now Gordon on first down. About 3 yards there to the 27.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. Working out of the gun, Mayfield escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation. Field goal coming from Youngway Koo. Right hash mark, a 42-yard attempt. Will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go.
Oh, Chubb fumbled it. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. He has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Still 9 yards to go on second down from the 27. Back to throw. Gordon. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down. Mayfield looks to throw. Rolling to his left. And he took the contact as he was throwing it. And the ball drops incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
And his kick is good. And they stretch the lead to 6. It's 20-14 now. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now, because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down.
Their own 18-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And that last turnover could have proven more costly, but their defense only gave up 3. But now answering with a field goal doesn't do them much on this drive. They need to try and find the end zone. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Moves to second and 10.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And all the way down to the 29. A big play there on the catch and run. 52 yards. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well, because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Julio Jones with his second touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Bills are an extra point away from taking the lead. And his kick is good.
Makes the score Bills 21, Dolphins 20.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
And this will make it into the end zone.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. They go play action. Mayfield. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And they will stop him short. They get him to the ground at the 27. No first down. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. Mayfield to throw for it on 4th. And it's complete to Kelsey. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on 4th. A great Monday night to wrap up the week in football. 2 division rivals and a great finish ahead as we come up on 1st and 10. The busy night continues for Gordon as he gets it here. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4 at the 42-yard line.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Gordon. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
It's a pickup of 12. Second play in a row with a 12-yard gain.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Now a play fake here on first down. Going up top for Kupp. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And the Bills first down.
On the ground, it's Chubb. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
At the 32-yard line.
Now it looks like he'll throw here, and this one's incomplete. This is a very important drive, and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
Buying time to his left. And that will be incomplete.
Ray certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Looking up into the lights, and he muffs it. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now, it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away. Live to fight another down.
And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Now Mayfield on fourth down. Open man is Gordon, complete. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
First down, Jack, at the 28-yard line.
Now Mayfield, flush to his right. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full
charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Got to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 18 big yards on that one, and a Miami first. Mayfield flushed out right, and that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Thrown to the sideline and incomplete.
Let's go.
Brings up second and 10.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Instead, it brings up third down.
Brings up third down and 10.
A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. One last shot for Mayfield here. Man open, it's Kupp, he's got it. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Tonight,
well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Bills, it's a nice win to finish off what's been an ugly first half as they move to 2-6. And they'll return home next week to take on the New England Patriots. Meanwhile, for Miami, they fall two games under 500 now at 3-4.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask. Can I?
Hey, could kind of my power and look at my dog. Some... Way back then, you could claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how did you get up? I done got rich, then went broke, then got rich again, just a little hiccup. I done been ballin' this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. How did the lady go miss? How she was magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the functions, we caught a little rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask. Can I?
Before I went live, they ain't know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Need a light year to protect my buzz. He's right here to protect my cup. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, they ain't never seen too much. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with some cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said. What's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask. Can I?
Philly. He's a bozo. Bozo. Really?
Yeah. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again.